제일 중요한 거는 영화는 영화라는 그 일을 하는 데 있었고 어느 나라에서 왔건 서로 문화를 서로 갖고 있는 생각을 그 일하는 나라에 맞춰서 체인지할 필요는 없다는 게 되게 놀랍고 되게 훌륭한 예술인 것 같습니다. 영화가.
This statement couldn't be more true coming from South Korean cinematographer Chung-Hoon Chung. Chung started in the industry as a child actor before attending Dongguk University, where he focused his passion and time on becoming a cinematographer. He debuted as a feature filmmaker in 1996 with the film Eerie, and soon garnered the attention of renowned South Korean director Park Chan-Wook. Chung found himself gaining recognition as a talented cinematographer, both in South Korea and across the globe. Since then, he has specialized in the suspense and thriller genre, using his own unique style to expertly craft a tense environment for the audience to become immersed in. But all of this does beg the question, what does his filmmaking style entail, and how has he evolved as a cinematographer? Consider this your spoiler warning and a chance to locate the nearest exit as we begin a deep dive into the cinematic evolution of Chung-Hoon Chung. As was touched upon earlier, Chung-Hoon Chung is considered to be the right-hand man of Park Chan-Wook, given how often the two have worked together, such as on Thirst, Stoker, Lady Vengeance, I'm a Cyborg and That's Okay, The Handmaiden, and, well, you get the point. The start of their legendary dynamic as a cinematographer-director duo can be best seen in their first collaboration, Oldboy. Released in 2003, Oldboy is a South Korean psychological action thriller about the protagonist, Dae-soo, seeking revenge against the man who kidnapped and locked him in a prison for nearly 15 years. Chung-Hoon Chung's unique shooting style when considering his use of lighting is quite evident given the meticulous lighting design used for the film. For example, although fluorescent lighting is often avoided in the industry as it can appear green on camera, according to Park Chan-Wook in an interview with Vanity Fair, this was intentional to generate suspense in a scene.
어떤 상황에선 그린이라고 하는 것은 굉장히 뭐 시원하고 맑고 자연을 연상하는 그런 그린도 있을 수 있고요. 이 영화에서 또 이 씬에서는 그것과는 다르게 뭔가 부식된 것 같은 낡고 뭔가 썩은 것 같은 곰팡이나
To contrast this suspense and suggest to the viewer that Dae-soo might have more control or freedom than before, Chung-Hoon Chung utilized warm, tungsten lighting and/or sunlight to create a natural and emotion-driven image. Aside from the lighting design of the film, the other notable feature of Chung-Hoon Chung's shooting style would have to be both his composition of a shot and the lens chosen to create it. To establish the location of a scene, Chung would use a wide-angle lens with a deep depth of field, allowing the audience to understand where the plot is taking place. After all, the opening rooftop scene wouldn't have as much weight to it had he chosen to stick with a close-up of each character. The use of the wide-angle lens and deep depth of field was also imperative in the shooting of the prominent one-take corridor brawl scene. While discussing the film in the same interview with Vanity Fair, Park Chan-wook had Chung-Hoon Chung do this to subvert the expectation of the audience.
제가 좋아하는 것이 바로 관객의 오도인데 클로즈업이 많고 빠르게 움직이고 다이나믹한 그런 액션 장면을 자동으로 기대하게 되겠지만 전혀 이제 그것을 따르지 않고 배반하게 되죠.
When wanting the audience to focus on a character and become more intimate with their struggle, Chung-Hoon Chung would then use a telephoto lens with a shallow depth of field because, similar to what was touched on before, the theme wouldn't hold as much weight if in a wide shot. While discussing his work with Park Chan-wook in an interview with Eastern Kicks, Chung-Hoon Chung stated, quote, I believe that if a cinematographer has an idea, then it's the director and his or her capacity to accept that which ultimately makes both a good director and a great collaboration. But does his statement remain true when working with another South Korean director? Post the release of Oldboy in 2003, Chung-Hoon Chung found himself working on the set of Ryu Sung-Won's The Unjust, a 2010 crime thriller about police officer Choi Chul-gi and public prosecutor Ju Yang vying for dominance as an innocent man is framed as a serial killer tormenting the nation. Although sticking with the thriller genre, there is a major difference in Chung's shooting style when comparing The Unjust to Oldboy. For example, the lighting design of the film is less complicated and is often dependent on the time and location of a scene. When a scene is taking place during the morning, such as when Chul-gi is at the police station, Chung used sunlight, which can appear blue on camera, to give the image a more natural yet bleak look and allow what little warmth there is to pop. To contrast this cool lighting, when a scene is taking place at night, such as when Ju Yang is threatening Chul Gi in his livelihood, Chung instead used practical tungsten lighting, which also allowed the scene to come across as more intense than before to the audience. Fluorescent lighting is also used in The Unjust, but in one particular scene, where Choi Chul-gi is ordered to frame an innocent man as a killer, psychologically signaling to the audience the beginning of the corruption of his character. Otherwise, the lighting design of The Unjust is simple and almost unoriginal compared to the one in Oldboy, but that's the point. The Unjust isn't a movie about revenge or hypnosis or having an unknown sexual relationship with your own daughter. It is about corruption in the justice system as corrupt people struggle for power in their respective field. The plot is realistic, ergo the lighting design is too. Aside from the simple lighting design, although Chung-Hoon Chung worked with director Ryu Sung-Won instead of Park Chan-Wook on The Unjust, he never diverged from the composition style presented in Oldboy. The best example of this can be witnessed in the scene where Ju Yang is having a meltdown. Similar to what was done in Oldboy, Chung used a telephoto lens with a shallow depth of field to have the viewer focus on Yang and his mounting rage. Then, to capture the reaction of the rest of the staff as his tirade is progressing, Chung used a wide-angle lens with a deep depth of field. The main divergence in composition between The Unjust and Oldboy would have to be that climactic skirmish near the end of the movie. While Park Chan-wook avoided using a close-up or dynamic sequence in his corridor brawl scene, Ryu Sung-Won chose to use what can be considered the standard shooting pattern, having Chung-Hoon Chung switch between a telephoto and wide-angle lens, and ultimately giving the sequence a more intense and fast-paced feeling. It is quite evident by now that Chung-Hoon Chung has almost perfected his shooting style when working on a South Korean production with a South Korean director. But since his vast filmography isn't limited to South Korea, how does his work compare when shooting across the globe? Although The Unjust and Oldboy have demonstrated the versatility and genius of Chung-Hoon Chung in their own unique form, neither of them can quite compare to the psychedelic journey he worked on that is Last Night in Soho. Released in 2021 and directed by Edgar Wright, Last Night in Soho is a British-American psychological thriller revolving around the protagonist, Eloise, and her encounter with the 1960s each night when she goes to sleep. This is the film where Chung-Hoon Chung was able to be more creative with his style and experiment with the lighting design, which was more color motivated than in his previous work. To establish a sense of realism and immerse the audience in Eloise's world, the lighting design is often simple and akin to the one presented in The Unjust. For example, when shooting a scene at night, according to an interview with IndieWire, Chung, quote, motivated a great deal of the night exterior lighting via neon signs and practical lights emanating from the buildings of the Soho streets. When shooting a scene taking place in the morning, Chung-Hoon Chung once again utilized natural sunlight to give the image a cooler, brighter, and calmer look compared to the darker and restless warm lighting used at night. But then there is the multicolor lighting design used by Chung to illustrate the difference between the world Eloise knew and the one she is living vicariously through in the 1960s. A perfect example of this can be seen when Sandy, the woman whose life Eloise is experiencing, is forced to dance to please a bunch of men at a party. The multicolored kaleidoscopic lighting implemented gave the club a more realistic look while also disorienting the viewer, mimicking Sandy's deteriorating mental state. Another perfect example of this color-driven lighting can be seen when Eloise is envisioning both Sandy and her toxic lover, Jack, bathed in red lighting as their relationship is worsening, hinting to the viewer that, although Sandy is being manipulated by Jack, the two have a darker side that is yet to be revealed. While there was hope that Chung-Hoon Chung would also experiment with his composition style as he did with his lighting design, this is unfortunately not the case. The same monotonous pattern that was seen in both The Unjust and Oldboy is persistent in Last Night in Soho. A telephoto lens is used to focus on a character, and a wide-angle one is used to establish a location. However, in spite of this pattern, Chung-Hoon Chung took a risk with Last Night in Soho by experimenting with various iconic shots in the movie. Take, for example, the mirror scene when Sandy is meeting Jack for the first time. Director Edgar Wright described this process best in his interview with Vanity Fair.
What's clever here is that Thomasin is actually really standing next to Anya Taylor-Joy. So what you're actually seeing here is like half a mirror. There's a mirror right here because obviously you can see Matt Smith's real reflection, and that's Matt Smith. On this side, there is a green screen behind Thomasin McKenzie so that she can be standing in like a hole in this set next to Anya Taylor-Joy.
What is intriguing and awe-inspiring about Chung-Hoon Chung is that no matter what he has worked on, he is able to shine as a cinematographer while also bringing the vision of the director to life. He has built for himself an incredible career in the industry and has continued to evolve as time goes on. As I bring this video to a close, I want to end with what I believe to be a valuable piece of advice for upcoming filmmakers. In the same interview with IndieWire, Chung-Hoon Chung stated, quote, "I'm not a good DP, meaning I don't know how to make something beautiful. I don't care about the camera when I read the script. I think about character and story. The camera movements and lighting follow naturally from that understanding of what the script is really about. If I don't understand the characters, the lighting's not going to be right."
Is flicking dimly